Olá pessoas, tudo bom? Aqui a gente ainda não tinha ido, né? Eu não consigo mexer. Faltam só quatro já. Ah, o visual dos dois, ó. Cara, parece o Bofill mesmo. Seria a Cisne Negra e o Bofill, os dois são, na verdade, os Inominados. Só que faz tanto tempo que eles já não lembram mais disso. Seria bem estranho, mas faz sentido, por incrível que pareça. Meu Deus. Aí. Ó, a hora que você termina aqui, né? Tá faltando ali só quatro passarinhos, né? Para completar aqui, né? Então você pode vir aqui, ó, no Doutor Azul. Preciso de uma dica. Aí vai pedir para você dar uma moeda. Ah, tá na área que a gente não foi ainda. Beleza. Ah, fiquei sem moeda. Como é que eu pego mais? Vem aqui, ó, na Hora Dourada, né? Neste cantinho aqui, ó, tem esse cara aqui, ó, Dance. E provavelmente não sei, eu tá chamando o Raul aí, né? Mas é porque eu mudei a bagaça dele, que eu não. Coisa. Aí, ó, toda semana ele tem 10 aqui pra você comprar. Tá, então pode comprar. Acumule mais de 77 fichas. Jogador de sorte. Ajude 100 pássaros do Unigami, meu Deus. Abre o menu.
Everyone, let's gather over here. We still need to make some preparations.
Vamos lá agora, vamos em frente. Agora é a hora do quebra-pau nervoso.
I may have been quick to step up to the plate, but confronting the Dream Master could be a very dangerous affair.
Huh? Even you're saying that, Mr. Yang? How powerful is that Dream Master?
He's the leader of the families of Penacony, and he has the entire power of the Harmony behind him. Not to mention the Stellaron in his possession. We must proceed with great caution.
Maybe you can just stay behind this time, Mr. Yang?
No, that won't do. Even if we count Robin as an ally, something felt off about Mr. Sunday just now. Although, I can't quite put my finger on it. I have to make sure he won't turn against us when things start to get dicey. You're still carrying the keepsake the IPC envoy gave you, right? May I borrow it for a moment? Huh. I knew it. As I suspected, this chip Aventurine gave to you is actually a miniature transmitter. If I'm right, he intends to use it to track your location or contact you when needed. As it so happens, this may actually be of some use in the currency.
Aventurine? Is he still alive? And what does he have to do with our mission to confront the Dream Master?
Remember what I said earlier? Working with the IPC is a way to keep the family in check. If negotiations go south and the family show their true colors by going after the Stellaron, I'll use this transmitter to send a message to the IPC. It'll be just the opportunity the IPC ambassador was hoping for. The only question mark in all of this is Venturine's current status. But the IPC is always listening, especially senior strategic investment department heads like him. Getting the message across shouldn't be a problem.
Good luck to you, Welt.
Well, you take care too. If anything goes wrong, don't worry about me. Just make sure to seal the Stellaron.
Spoken like a true hero. Even if the Dream Master is innocent, the family's corruption runs deep. I won't make the same mistake Mikhail did. Let's wish him the best of luck.
Don't you have something else to tell us, Gallagher?
Why would you say so?
Before we departed, the conductor asked us to inquire about the three nameless in Penacony. We've already collected intel about Rosalina and Tiernan, so the only one left is Lightwork.
Gasta Sola.
If I'm not mistaken,
adoro esses nomes.
We've already met him somewhere, haven't we?
Ficou triste que a Firefly não é vagalume.
It's not enough to say meet, but the answer is pretty obvious. After all, I've hinted at it in quite an evident way. I've been watching over you ever since I received the reply from the Astral Express, and I've seen the great effort you all put into linking different realms together across the cosmos. And now, after getting this far all in one piece, you have truly proven yourselves. Miss Himiko, were you the one who repaired the Express and got it sailing through the cosmos again?
Yes.
And you two, young Nameless, you have very interesting life stories and extraordinary skills.
I don't know much about my life story, but I do have extraordinary skills.
You're full of energy. Please send my regards to the conductor, Pom Pom. Please let them know that their friend had fond memories from his time aboard the Express, which he reminisced on every time he had a good drink. As for the last Nameless, he embarked, disembarked, and embarked again, traveling in a great circle, ending up back where he started. On his deathbed, he told me to find the Astral Express and deliver an invitation to the future Nameless. He left behind a special gift, a true legacy. Something that belongs only to the successors of the Trailblaze. Come with me. Now, is the time to reveal it.
Caralho, chegou a arrepiar aqui.
Sometimes I feel like you're still alive, old friend. Like you've still got so much to say and do. I've kept my promise, brought the future trailblazers you've waited so long for. I don't know why you were so obsessed with that train, but I remember your last words. Don't let us down, old man.
Cutscene foda? Quiser aparecer? Aí, obrigado. Ficou meio esquisito essa cutscene, mas tudo bem. Lies in the garden up ahead.
First and last nameless of Penacony. Mikhail Char Legward, the Watchmaker.
Realmente o último nominado era o relojoeiro, que nem eu tinha deduzido antes. Eu tinha suspeitado, mas não tinha certeza. Vamos ver se a gente acha mais um pardal aqui. Eu sabia que tem um pardal lá no fim das asfalto. Porquinho só aparece depois e o Lorde da Latidis também, então... Falando nisso, ainda falta fazer um porquinho e uma horda da lata de lixo. Por baixo da superfície do mar, usando a memória. Um jardim próximo à lua sob a água. O germe carrega a sola, foi de onde ele fica parado. Hein? Aquele bagulho que eu falei que parecia um útero, né? Faz todo sentido.
O Watchmaker é o terceiro nameless. Até eu poderia guessar esse.
A legacy que ele deixou atrás foi um bubble. I believe inside that bubble, there's something that holds meaning only for the nameless. After all, when I checked its contents, I found nothing inside. Maybe some trailblaze runes? Even more mysterious than me.
Well, let's have a look.
E o corpo dele ficou lá, né? No mundo dos sonhos pra sempre. Ele morreu de velhice, pelo jeito, né?
Just as I suspected. That old man always had this strange belief in the nameless and the trailblaze. And I never understood where he got that confidence from. Especially since he never managed to get in touch with the Express while he was alive. I could never figure out what was going on in that old man's head. But this empty dream bubble is so typical of him. He was always full of weird fantasies and incomprehensible romanticism. That mischievous old man. Well, I didn't expect him to leave anything concrete behind anyway.
Don't think that's the case, Gallagher. I'm sure Mikhail has left us the most precious thing of all.
Don't start getting all philosophical on me, all right?
Just as Mikhail believes in the nameless of the future, we unconditionally believe in the nameless of the past. How could they leave with regrets for the future when they were ready to dedicate their lives to the land they loved? There must be something contained in this dream bubble. It's just we haven't figured it out yet. You also have faith in the Watchmaker, don't you, Gallagher?
Well, I'm a follower of the Enigmata. My philosophy forbids me to have faith in anything. That's why I understand what faith means in the path of Trailblaze. And I also want to know what he left behind. I'll leave it to you guys then.
Can I borrow your pet? I need to make a trip back to Golden Hour and check something at the Dreamscape sales store. It's for Mikhail, and for the future of Penacony.
Aí vamos pro Rio de novo.
Welcome to the Reverie Hotel. How may I help you?
Greetings. We're the Nameless from the Astral Express, and we'd like to check in.
The Astral Express? But I thought...
Yes, my companions already checked in. My name is Dan Hung, and I believe my personal information is recorded in your system.
I see, but your companion said you wouldn't be coming due to a change of plans.
Now the plans have changed again.
And you are...
Me? I'm Pom Pom. A new Nameless, who's also with the Astral Express.
He's my fellow trailblazer. We responded to the family's invitation before he boarded the Express. So he wasn't registered in your system. Is it possible to accommodate him as well?
Oh, I see. Another one of the Nameless had a similar situation. Seems like a lot of people are joining the Trailblaze these days. Since there's a precedent, it shouldn't be a problem. Just give me a second to contact your companions. I'm sorry, dear guests, but it seems I'm unable to reach the other members of the Astral Express.
What do you mean by unable to reach them?
My apologies. This is the first time I've encountered a situation like this. However, the system indicates that those guests are still in the Dreamscape.
How about this? Give me their room number, and we'll go check on them ourselves.
I'm afraid that's not possible. I need to verify both of your identities before I can share any guest information.
How about you just wake up someone? Let's say, Welt.
I'm sorry, but there are strict rules regarding forced awakening. It cannot be done without the proper clearance.
So nothing works, huh? What's your solution, then? Are you saying we sleep here? At the reception?
Please be patient. We need to contact your companions in order to confirm your identities.
And now it seems you need to confirm our identities before you can contact our companions.
It seems so.
Oh, fudge! Look, nothing personal, but if you can't handle this, go find someone else who can, okay?
Please calm down, dear guests. I do recall that Mr. Sunday, the Oak family head, personally handled this issue earlier. Oh, please wait a moment while I contact him.
I don't think she's trying to give us a hard time. She really just doesn't know what to do.
I have a bad feeling about this. You tried to contact them on the express earlier, but they didn't respond.
Something doesn't seem right. I need to leave for a moment. You can stay here with the receptionist.
Sure thing. Just don't keep me waiting forever.
Both eu... Nominho engraçado.
Give him some space. Stressing out about it won't help anything.
Que eu ganhei aqui? Interaja com o relojoeiro. Vambora.
The Germany Festival is about to start. I'm so excited!
Hey! You guys here for the Germany Festival too?
Well, I didn't come all the way here specially for the festival. Honestly, I don't really even know what it's about, but I heard it's a lot of fun!
Well, back in my home world, Anaria, we have festivals like that all the time. My dad threw me a birthday party one time that was just as extravagant as the Charmany Festival.
Oh, come on! The Charmany Festival is a once-in-an-amber-era event. How can a birthday party compare?
Well, you never know, right? Maybe on her world, birthdays only happen once in Amber Era. Anyway, let's forget about that. Have you heard about the, unsettling things happening in the Dreamscape?
Unsettling things? What could possibly go wrong? It better not ruin the Charmany Festival! I've been looking forward to it!
Relax. With a big event like this, there's bound to be lots of gossip and rumors. Don't worry. If anything does happen, the family will be on top of it.
Oh, that's a relief. I didn't come all this way to see the festival go down the drain. Well... Looks like I won't get any fudging clues out of these two. They're clueless.
É da hora as frases dele. Eu não vi de onde os nominados perderam as botas.
Greetings. I'm Cody of the Bloodhound family, head of security for the hotel. How may I assist you?
Hello. So, there's something I wanted to ask about. I've been hearing some unsettling rumors about certain incidents that might affect the Charmany Festival. Do you think there's anything to be worried about? I've traveled all the way from the Hayai Federation, and I don't want my trip to be ruined.
What do you mean?
Wait. You haven't heard?
I'm not sure where you heard those rumors, but they're completely baseless. I can assure you, as a representative of the Bloodhound family, that everything is going smoothly for the Charmany Festival. At present, all of the families are focused on making sure the festival starts on time. Even the Dream Master himself has arrived. So don't worry, your trip won't be in vain.
Ah. That's a relief to hear. She doesn't appear to be acting. So, it seems that even the hotel staff are out of the loop. Back already?
Hasn't she returned yet?
Nope. I'm starting to wonder if sending her to contact Sunday was a good idea. Neither the staff nor the guests seem to know anything about what's happening in the Dreamscape, and wherever we go, all we see is people enjoying themselves. Definitely not a good sign.
I agree. Another unusual thing is that the Oak family is supposed to be in charge of organizing the council and managing everything inside and outside the dreamscape. However, I walked around the hotel, but didn't meet a single member of the Oak family on such an important day.
Well, I'll be forked. If I remember correctly, the head of the Oak family is that Sunday guy, right?
We shouldn't linger here too long. Let's go back to the Express for now.
Not so fast. Have you ever robbed the IPC, bro? If you run away now, everyone will be chasing after you.
Are you suggesting we sit here and do nothing?
I wouldn't say do nothing, but let's stay put for now. Even if the family has ulterior motives, they couldn't have anticipated us showing up here. We're the surprise factor for them. They don't want to attract unwanted attention from certain outsiders, so they won't do anything reckless. See? The IPC lackeys are keeping a close eye on this hotel.
Ah, é, né? A Topaz tá do lado de fora, né? Com a galera.
I'd find an official excuse and keep the surprise factors here. If we just wait here, that would be like walking into their trap.
Of course, we don't need to walk into their trap. I gave a backup plan to the memo keeper. If it turns out we won't be allowed to enter the dreamscape, she'll order a drink for me in the VIP lounge at the hotel. In reality,
a secret signal.
That's right.
Oh, a concrete object can indeed help the memo keeper establish a connection with you. But Boot Hill, if you have more backup plans in the future, I hope you'll let me know in advance.
I'm sorry, but it's one of my quirks. I have too many unreliable friends. And if I reveal that I have backup plans,
colocaram o jeitinho, ficou bom, mas ele disse trejeito, né? Quirks.
And that would leave all backup plans completely useless.
How do we get into the VIP lounge?
This is where my street smarts come into play.
Ah, é, eu ia falar, né? É, o Bow Hill, ele é inspirado no Galaxy Rangers e Silverhawks, tá? Quem tiver interesse aí em dar uma olhada em umas imagens na internet, vocês vão ver, né? Até a estrela que tem no peito dele aqui é inspirada lá nos Galaxy Rangers, né? Todo o conceito e esse corpo mecânico do Silverhawks e tudo mais, né? E a Robin, ela é inspirada na Marilyn Monroe, né? Inclusive, no trailer oficial dela, ela tem uma cena em que ela faz a pose da Marilyn Monroe, né? Faz todo sentido, né, o conceito. E a Firefly é Tokusatsu no Ryu Kendo, cara. Meu, as inspirações dessa temporada aqui estão incríveis, né?
You're the lobby manager, right?
Yes, I am. How may I assist you?
We're the Nameless from the Astral Express. Yeah, we wanted to check in, but there's something wrong with your system. The lady at the front desk said she would contact the manager, but now she's nowhere to be found. Now, we've been waiting here forever, without any food or water. What the fork, man? Is this how the family treats its guests?
O jeito que ele fala é assim.
Starting an altercation.
It's called standing up for your rights.
I apologize for the inconvenience. Please wait while we try to contact Mr. Sunday. I'll arrange two premium seats in the VIP lounge so you can rest there while you wait.
See? Just like that.
Just don't call yourself Nameless next time.
Wow, this bar's something else. Certainly worthy of the place. planning our festivities.
Good evening, gentlemen.
Hey, I have an order for a bottle of Asdana's White Oak. Can you help us find it?
Asdana's White Oak? I think there might be a misunderstanding. We don't serve that here.
Oh, no way. Are you sure you're not mistaken?
If someone had reserved such a beverage, I would definitely remember it. It sells for hundreds of thousands of credits per bottle, after all. I couldn't afford to cover for such an item if it were broken or lost.
That's strange. Well, could it be that the memo keeper couldn't afford it?
Then what should we do now?
Oh, no need to rush. Well, let's grab some drinks first. Maybe I arrived too early and she hasn't come yet. Let's see what kind of juice malts you all have here. Well, give me a glass of Heenum Valley, 40 years. I'll have it neat. No ice.
Wow, that's the most expensive one on the list. You have a taste for the finer things.
It's on the house, anyway.
What can I get for you?
Anything you recommend is fine.
Then I would recommend today's special, Glass Village. It's classic Soul Glad mixed with Laboon juice. It's refreshing and suits your cool demeanor. Just one minute.
Ah, this flavor. Dynamite barbecue with rocket fuel. Ooh! Really hits the spot. Truly the finest sherry cask aged malt juice in the cosmos.
Dynamite barbecue with rocket fuel, Earth. Is that really something that humans enjoy?
Hey, this guy doesn't know anything at all.
As long as you're satisfied, dear guests, please enjoy.
Ah, é, porque ele é um vidiatra, né? Ele não é humano, né? Que isso disso?
Let's take stock of the situation. What do you think?
The situation is unclear.
Cisne Negro desapareceu agora. O que tá acontecendo, né?
But the public is unaware of it. Someone in a position of power within the family must be covering it up. It's unusual for the followers of the Harmony to invite other factions, let alone the IPC and the Masked Fools. If what you said about the Emanator of the Nihility is true, the situation in Penacony is a little complicated, to say the least.
Actually, there's something else I'm concerned about, regarding Acheron. As you know, the faction that follows the path of the hunt are some of the most dangerous folks in the cosmos to mess with. I mean, who in the right mind would impersonate the Xianzhou Alliance or the Galaxy Rangers? It's like asking for a death wish. Isn't there a saying among the Xianzhou people that the Rainbow Sect lets their Lux Arrow do all the beating?
Talking. Do all the talking.
Well, you know what I mean. Even though the Galaxy Rangers have been out of sight for years, we've been keeping an eye on this region. Even the dumbest criminals know better than to mess with the Annihilation Gang, much less the Rangers. But that Acheron lady, she doesn't seem like a lunatic at all. On the contrary, she's highly logical and organized. She knows exactly when to hold back and when to strike without mercy.
And do you believe that someone like her would have an ulterior motive for impersonating a Galaxy Ranger?
I'm not entirely sure, but I do have my suspicions. Maybe she knows a Galaxy Ranger, or perhaps she's trying to lure us out for some reason. I can't figure out.
Anyway, what worries me more are the anomalies within the family. They've summoned followers from various paths for the festival. No matter how generous such a gesture is, this move seems highly unusual. Unless the invitations weren't sent by them. If that's the case, it's even more intriguing that the family insists on organizing the Charmony Festival, despite the chaos.
Maybe it's Shipei the Harmony pulling the strings. You find it beyond human understanding because it wasn't arranged by humans at all. People do stupid things out of irrational impulses. They abandon their principles when self-interest is involved. They believe in things they know they shouldn't, and fudge, they even break their own rules. But eons don't. They stick to their determined path and never turn back, even if they reach a dead end.
You think Shipei's will is behind all this?
It may not necessarily be Shipei. There's definitely some higher entity involved. I know it may sound pessimistic, but if human free will were reliable, why would we even need Galaxy Rangers? It's much simpler when you boil it down to the eons and paths. Like how Lon always follows the path of the hunt, or how the Express stays true to the Trailblaze despite Akavili's disappearance.
But in my opinion, Akavili's fall holds significance for the Nameless.
Oh, so you're saying the Nameless now have to take responsibility for their own choices because their absolutely right leader is gone?
Exactly. I believe the purpose of the journey isn't just about following a path that's always considered absolutely right. It's more about doing your best to choose the right path for yourself among countless possibilities, even with limited insight and judgment.
I don't know what you've been through, but I agree that people must take responsibility for their choices.
Olha, tudo indica que em breve a gente vai ter outro caminho e personagens desse novo caminho, porque tudo tá rumando pra gente ter um confronto direto com um dos Eons, né?
Have a backup plan if the memo keeper doesn't show up. This is my final backup plan. I promise.
You sure have a lot of cards up your sleeve.
Well, going back to my old career would make things a lot easier. By the way, when you were walking around the hotel, did you happen to see any important looking guests?
What's your plan?
It's simple. We just grab some hostages and use them as bargaining chips with the family. Or maybe we can even take their identities.
No need for that. We'll return to the Express now.
Wait. Are you getting scared? Draw your weapon. Let's make a big scene.
Are you leaving, esteemed guests? Would you like to cancel that Asdana's White Oak you just ordered?
Huh? Asdana's White Oak? But didn't you just say...
Ha ha. Looks like you are a bit intoxicated, esteemed guests. You ordered a bottle of Asdana's White Oak just a moment ago.
Looks like your memo keeper friend has finally arrived.
Ela enfiou a memória na cabeça do cara.
Sorry, my memory's not the best. You know, too many modifications and all. Anyway, let me check. Well, fork me. It says Donna's White Oak, all right. And there's a note. I'll be waiting for you on the Astral Express.
No mistake, that's her message to you. She knew the hotel wasn't safe, so she suggested we find another place.
Well, looks like we took a detour, but now it's back to the Astral Express. So, what are we waiting for? Let's go.
Let's go.
reported saying they were looking for Boot Hill, so I told them to wait in the parlor car.
Oh,
duas?
Just in time.
Two guests?
Yeah, or two. Look, we welcome all passengers on the Astral Express, but sneaking in like that, you have no regard for etiquette.
My apologies, Conductor. It was an oversight on my part. I assumed you were already acquainted with the garden. Given the chaotic situation in Penacony, the Nameless are the only ones we can truly trust right now.
You are the Memo Keeper.
Pleased to meet you, Don Hung. I've seen you in others' memories. And as for Boot Hill, this is our first face-to-face meeting. I hope you enjoyed that bottle of Astana's White Oak. You sure have a refined taste.
Finally, Memo Keeper. Well, let's cut to the chase. Spill everything you know.
That's precisely what I intend to do. But before that, please allow me to introduce myself. My name is Black Swan, and I serve the Garden of Recollection as a Memo Keeper. As for Acheron's story, I'm sure she knows it better than I do.
Greetings. I'm Acheron.
What? You Garden of Recollection shirtbag! You betrayed me!
I apologize, but she did that at my request. Due to certain reasons, I have been exiled by the family. Thankfully, this Memo Keeper came to my aid and helped me escape their surveillance unnoticed.
To be honest, it was more like stalking than helping. And the process was far from unnoticed. But we did escape.
I asked her to guide me to a place beyond the family's reach and to contact a few trustworthy individuals, namely all of you.
Trustworthy? Son of a nice lady, you think I'm dumb or something? How about this? I'll put a few bullet holes in your head and see what secrets spill out. Then, we can talk about trust.
It doesn't have to be like that. I'm willing to answer all your questions, but not right now. If my cover hadn't been blown, we might have had more time, but at the moment, we don't have any other options.
No other options? What do you mean?
This is the only way I can ensure everyone's safety. I kindly request an immediate warp jump out of the Astana star system.
Is requesting?
As far as I can tell, she's not a threat and seems to be telling the truth.
I've briefly traveled with your companions and know their whereabouts, Don Hung. Please rest assured, your nameless companions are safe, but they need our help. As for Boot Hill, you may have guessed, I've been waiting for you. Galaxy Rangers are known for their elusive nature and limited contact with each other. So this was the only way I could reach out to you. Only by doing this can I find a true Galaxy Ranger and fulfill a long-standing promise. To return his relics to their rightful owner. Someone once told me...
Que plot twist maluco é esse?
...all is like a gift. From the heavens, a sign of their mercy upon the world. Raindrops are said to be the tears of the gods, shed in response to the sorrows of the world. Their constant pouring is a reminder that the gods haven't abandoned us yet. So, how long has this rain been going on for?
I used to believe, just like you, that it would eventually stop. Years and decades passed. And in the end, such hope faded away before the rain did. Looks like the god you mentioned doesn't exist after all. Well, let me share a story. Mortals who walk the paths are like sailors on a vast ocean, leaving behind a trail that creates countless ripples of possibilities. These ripples last longer than the fleeting lifetimes of humans. And for some, their presence leaves such a strong mark that it's reflected in the waves.
Like those shadows on the ocean.
Sin-thirsters, the obsessions of the Path Strangers. They emerge from the depths of IX, seeing themselves as masters of their own destiny, unknowingly repeating the actions of their past lives. They emerge from the nihility and head toward it, leading purposeless lives. However, hollow phantoms. They were once my dear companions. A group of galaxy rangers.
Are you watching over them?
Watching over them? No. I'm guiding them toward transcendence. It was a brutal war. A crusade that shook the universe. The universe witnessed the fall of Zulo, the Lord Ravager, but it came at a price.
Nossa.
A price so hefty that only those who were there still remember. The unwavering determination of the hunt followers persists even in death. So someone must guide these lost souls to their life beyond. They were heroes in their time. And they shouldn't be reduced to mere puppets of the nihility. As for me, I've suffered too many losses on that battlefield to advance any further. And that makes me the most fitting person to carry out this task.
But you know, these sin-thirsters, they're not who they used to be.
Does this seem pointless to you? Well, some tasks have to be done, even if they are pointless.
I can help you.
For what?
For the meaning of the nihility. That's what I've been seeking.
I see. After all, this realm is off limits to ordinary souls, right? Thank you, stranger. I wish that you find what you seek.
Before we part ways, I have one more question. It is true that their actions and even their entire lives may seem pointless from our perspective. But if, and it's just an if this is what the departed ones expected, should we try to change it?
A good question. and a profound one. I don't know the answer. What I do know is that one day I too will pass away. And when I bid farewell to this world, someone will stand at my grave and place a bouquet of flowers on it.
O tempo para Robin. 9 horas.
When I appeared as a child, my speech, mindset, and soul reflected immaturity and innocence. As I grew into adulthood, I left behind my childlike side.
I humbly request your blessings, esteemed advocate of Shipe.
Come to me, my kinship. I have sought their presence with us.
As you wish. I have faithfully served the Alfalfa family for nearly a decade. Promoting the path of the harmony to the best of my
ability. Gente, a gente continua no próximo episódio, porque, como vocês podem ver, não acaba o diálogo. E aí vai acabar cortando no meio do episódio o negócio, então vai acabar aqui, tá bom? Falou, valeu, até mais, fui!